वेलकम टू टॉप 100 मोस्ट आस्क्ड नेटवर्क इंजीनियर इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर सीरीज गाइज आई एम गोइंग टू अपलोड 20 वीडियोज इन दिस सीरीज 20 वीडियोज एंड ईच वीडियो विल कवर 5 इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन बट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट यू नो दैट दिस इज नॉट 100 क्वेश्चन ऑफ नेटवर्किंग और 100 क्वेश्चन ऑफ CCNA दिस इज 100 मोस्ट आस्क्ड Network engineer interview question, right? So this is day one. This is video number one. Now I am going to cover 5 questions today. 5 important questions for network engineer interview, right? And tomorrow I will cover 5 more. Then 5 more. Then 5 more. 5 more. So in 20 videos, each video contains 5. Question. So total number of question will be 100 in 20 days. In 20 days, right? So you need to spend just 10 to 12 minutes per day. Only 10 to 12 minutes per day, right? So within 20 days, you will have good command on these 100 questions, which is most important for interview, right? So let's start. Let me see question number one, right? And if you have any query or concern, you can WhatsApp me on this number, right? Let's see question number first. So question number first is, what is LAN? LAN stands for local area network, but in interview, you have to explain what is LAN, right? So see what is LAN. LAN stands for local area network, right? Local area network. Because basically it is a small network. It is a small network that connect all computer devices along with other networking devices like hub and switch, right? So LAN is group of devices which are connected through other networking device. It is a group of computer. You can say group of computers which are connected to other networking device like hub or switch, okay, and so that they can communicate, right? Now this user is able to communicate with this user or not, right? Till then, if this user is not able to communicate with this computer, that means it's not pure LAN, right? So LAN means group of computers which are connected to each other through switch or hub, through other networking device, so that they are able to communicate with each other, right? Is known as local area network. We divide network on the basis of area, right? If interviewer ask you that in LAN network how many user can be exist, right? So you have to answer that network, we divide network on the basis of area, not on the basis of user. So we can't define how many user can be there in a LAN network. Fine. So we divide networks on the basis of area and works within limited area. And LAN works within limited area, such as building, a school, lab, university, campus, office building, right? So this type of network is known as LAN, local area network. This is your question number first. So interviewer can ask you, what is LAN, right? So it's your first question in your interview, what is LAN? Maybe second question will be, what is DHCP? You can't say DHCP stands for Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, and after that nothing, right? So you have to explain proper what is DHCP. So DHCP stands for Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. As it named Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, it's clear with their name that we are configuring a host, right? Configuring a host dynamically, right? So DHCP stands for Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, and DHCP is Network Management Protocol. DHCP is a network management protocol which is used for automatically assigning IP address and other communication parameters. So other parameters means like subnet mask, default gateway, default gateway and DNS IP address, right? So these are the other communication parameters which DHCP server will provide to client. Okay, so what is DHCP? DHCP stands for Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. DHCP is a network management protocol which is used for automatically assigning IP address and other communication parameters to the client, right? And DHCP work on DORA process, and it use port number 67 and 68. Okay, use port number 67 and 68. And what is the meaning of DORA? DORA means, guys, D stand for discover, O stand for offer, R stand for request, and A stand for acknowledgement, right? So actually what is happening over here, let me explain you through this diagram. So suppose this is my switch, and here is one user, and here is DHCP server. Is DHCP server. Now how this device will get IP address from DHCP server? So actually this device will discover a message called discover message. This client will broadcast a discover message, right? This message will go to switch, then switch will broadcast it, right? So when server will receive this discover message, there will be source port and destination port. So source port will be 68, right? Actually 68 is using client and 67 is using server. Fine. So server is using 67 and client is using 68 port number, right? So port number, source port number will be 68 and destination port number will be 67. So when DHCP server will see destination port number is 67, that means this is a discover message for me. So I have to offer one IP address, right? So DHCP server will offer to client. DHCP server will generate a offer message, right? Then this client will confirm that to DHCP server, can I assign this IP address? Suppose DHCP server is offering 10.0.0.1, right, to the client. Now client is requesting to do a DHCP, right, that am I assign this IP address? Can I assign this IP address? Then DHCP server will acknowledge to the client, yes, you can assign this IP address 10.0.0.1. Then this client will assign. Fine. So this is DHCP. DHCP work on DORA process. Always keep in mind. Okay, so you need to explain what is DHCP. Just if you are saying DHCP stands for Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol and blah blah blah, then it's wrong, right? So you have to answer properly to the interviewer. Fine. So second question is DHCP. Maybe your third question can be DNS. What is DNS, right? So guys, DNS stands for domain name system or domain name server. So DNS is a protocol which is used to resolve IP address from domain name, For example, when a web address or URL, guys, URL stands for Uniform Resource Locator, right? Uniform Resource Locator. So when a web address type in a browser, right, just like web address of google.com is www.google.com. so when we type web address in a browser, right, so DNS server provides IP address to the web server. DNS server will provide IP address of web server to the client or associated with the name, with that name, right? So what is DNS? DNS stands for domain name system. DNS is a protocol which is used to resolve IP address from domain name. For example, when a web address or URL is entered in a browser, DNS server provides IP address to the web server associated with that name, right? Just like I am typing आई एम ओपनिंग माई ब्राउजर एंड टाइपिंग www.facebook.com. facebook.com, right? So DNS server will provide IP address of www.facebook.com to the client, right? Because client can't access Facebook server with domain name. Client need IP address of Facebook server. So who will provide IP address to the client? DNS server, right? DNS server. So DNS converts URL. Suppose my URL is www.pmnetworking.com. So DNS server will convert this domain name into IP address. Suppose my HTTP server IP address is 192.168.10.1. So DNS server will tells to my client that IP address of www.pmnetworking.com is 192.168.10.0. Just like this is my client, right? This is my switch. Here is one HTTP server, PM networking server, and there is one DNS server, right? So suppose IP address of HTTP server is 192.168.10.1 and DNS server IP address is suppose 10.2 and client IP address is suppose 10.3. So if I open browser on this PC and type www.pmnetworking.com, so my machine will not directly hit HTTP server. My machine will generate a message for DNS server first to ask what is the IP address of www.pmnetworking.com. Then DNS server provides IP address to the client. Okay, so IP address of www.pmnetworking.com is 192.168.10.1. Then your PC, then client will hit HTTP server. Fine. So this is DNS. This question is very important. So you have to answer proper answer. What is DNS? Right? What is DNS? Fine. And your fourth question is, what is window in networking terms? Right? What is window or windowing? Okay. So a window refers to the number of segments that are allowed to be sent from source to destination before an acknowledgement is sent back. Actually, window is a technique which we are using to reduce the number of acknowledgement. That's it, right? Actually, if you remember TCP, transmission control protocol, TCP is a layer 4 protocol, right? Work at transport layer. But TCP is a connection oriented protocol, right? TCP is a reliable protocol. Fine. So TCP is a reliable protocol. That means whenever a client will send traffic, right? Server, my destination device will acknowledge, yeah, I received your message, I received your data. Just like this is my PC and I have one router, right? And I enable Telnet on this router. Telnet. Right, these are connected together. Fine. So when I access Telnet at transport layer before sending actual data, this PC will build a connection with this device, right? This device with destination device. And whenever this PC will send a message to router, the router will acknowledge to the PC that yes, I receive your segment, right? So suppose this client is sending 5 segment 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if this router will acknowledge 5 times, then communication will be very slow, right? So we use windowing technique to reduce the number of acknowledgement, right? If I set window size 5, so after 5 segment, this device will acknowledge to the client, right? This PC. That okay, I receive your 5 segment. Fine. So window is a technique which we are using to reduce the number of acknowledgement, right? Otherwise communication will be very slow. Fine. And this is process carried out by transport layer. At which layer it's work? Windowing at transport layer. Fine. And your last question for the day is, what is OSI model, right? What is OSI model? This is your last question for this video, right? Five next question I will discuss in next video, right? So you have to spend only 10 to 15 minutes per day. 10 to 15 minutes per day. After 20 days, you will have good knowledge of 100 most asked interview question. Okay? So last question is OSI model. What is OSI model? So guys, OSI stands for Open System Interconnection. Open System Interconnection. OSI model is a process which tells us how two applications communicate in a network, right? OSI model is a process which tells us how two applications communicate in a network. OSI model is developed to make communication possible between different vendor devices. It has 7 layers: application layer, presentation layer, session layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, and physical layer. Fine. So what is OSI model? Actually, OSI model is process which tells us how two applications will communicate in a network, right? And actually, OSI model is telling how your data will out from your computer and how a data will enter in your computer, right? Suppose I have two computers. So these two computers are connected each other. So OSI model tells us how a data will out from this computer and how a data will enter in this computer, right? So this is a process which tells us how data will out from computer and how data enter in computer. If I talk about before OSI model, right? So it's not possible to communication was not possible between different vendor devices, right? Suppose I have one laptop of Dell and I have one laptop of HP. So modes of communication of Dell laptop was different and mode of communication of HP laptop was different. So that's the reason this device was not able to communicate with each other, right? So that's the reason why we develop OSI model, to make communication possible between Dell devices and HP devices, right? So OSI model is developed to make communication possible between different vendor devices. Now Dell is manufacturing their hardware and designing their software according to OSI model, right? And HP is also manufacturing their hardware and designing their software according to OSI model. Now modes of communication, now process is common, right? So that's the reason these two devices able to communicate. Now laptop of IBM can communicate with laptop of Apple, laptop of Dell, laptop of HP, right? So now every vendor devices is able to communicate with different vendor devices because of OSI model, right? Reason is only OSI model, because every vendor company is manufacturing their device and designing their software according to OSI model. Fine. So this is five most asked interview question. In next video, I will show you five more questions, right? Five more question. So within 20 days, you will get 100 question. Okay. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed this channel, please subscribe this channel so that whenever I will upload video, you will get notified. So don't forget to click on bell icon as well. And if you like this video, please hit on like button as well to let me know that you are understanding. Fine. Thank you. Thanks for watching.